Hello friends, a very warm welcome from our YouTube channel Open Knowledge, Empowering Self-Learning. Myself, Dr. Ajay Semaldi, and my team members, Dr. Mona Semaldi and Mr. Lokesh Adhikari, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Gadwal Institute, Srinagar Gadwal, welcome you. We hereby present you our first e-module on Research Indices, Part 1, Impact Factor. In this e-module, we will introduce the impact factor as a research index and discuss its importance and all other related aspects. Impact factor. It is the most important basis of selection of journal. It's a measure of the reputation of a journal. By definition, it's a measure of the frequency with which the average article in a journal has been cited in a particular year. A journal's impact factor is presented by a digit followed by year and name of impact factor providing agency in brackets. For example, on the home page of Expert Opinion Drug Delivery Journal, the impact factor is illustrated like this: 2016 impact factor 5.657, 2017 Clarivate Analytics, 2017 release of the JCR. It's a dynamic index which changes on the basis of citations and number of papers every year. How impact factor is calculated? In any given year, the impact factor of a journal is the number of citations received in that year of articles published in that journal during the two preceding years, divided by the total number of articles published in that journal during those two preceding years. For example, a journal's 2017 impact factor calculation will be impact factor 2017 is equal to citations 2016 plus citations 2015 divided by published papers 2016 plus published papers 2015. So if the citations of 2016 are 1450, citations of 2015 1550, we will add them up and divide them with the total number of published papers in 2016, that is 150, and total number of published papers in 2015, that is 260. It comes to 4.878. So impact factor will be 4.878. Now let's look upon who provides the impact factor. Now, first four are the agencies which provide the impact factor, like Journal Citation Report, Thomson Reuters, the Institute of Scientific Information, ISI, and Scopus, JCR, SJR, CiteSeer. Next, Science Citation Index and Social Science Citation Index, PubMed, and Web of Science are the indexing agencies, indexing services, which take care of these things. Apart from these four indexing agencies, several indexing agencies are there, like Scopus, Embase, Chemical Abstracts, Index Copernicus, Cite Factor, International Pharmaceutical Abstracts, Indian Citation Index, and obviously Google Scholar. So once the journal is indexed in reputed indexing services, the agencies keep track of citations and publications and then provide impact factor time to time. JCR releases the impact factor each year in the month of July. For example, in 2017 July, 2016 impact factor has been released. It is to be noted that self-declaration of impact factor by the journals is not valid. These agencies are globally recognized for analyzing and releasing the impact factor. Now, let's see on which factors impact factor depends on. Impact factor depends on, by definition, number one, number of papers published and citations. It depends on these two factors primarily. Secondly, presence in various indexing services. More a journal is indexed in various indexing services, higher are the chances of citations and hence getting the impact factor. Next is frequency of publication of journal. It is also a very important factor. A journal which is published fortnightly shall have more number of papers and chances of more citations as compared to the quarterly, monthly or bi-monthly journals. That's why getting these chances of and improving the impact factor is higher in these cases. Next factor is online nature and wide dissemination, open access. Open access journals are accessible by all readers and researchers freely. So more readers and researchers shall cite the papers and hence impact factor improves. Another factor is publisher's policies of self-citations. In some cases, some journals publishers poses on the authors the condition of citing a few of their own journal's paper, and this increases their citations, and thereby the chances of improving the impact factor of those journals are higher. Nature of journals, review only and interdisciplinary. In both the cases, review only journals and interdisciplinary journals, they attract more readers, more researchers, and hence chances of citations and impact factor improves. Miscellaneous factors, they are equally important. The quality of manuscript, better the quality of manuscript, better will be the citation. Presentation quality, the presentation quality of manuscript makes it easy to understand by the readers and researchers. A nicely presented manuscript is likely to be cited more. Many journals have started adding introductory videos and data set with manuscripts as supplementary resources. This improves their presentation quality. Now, impact factor in academic recognition. How impact factor plays its role in academic recognition? The academic performance indicators as prescribed by University Grants Commission of India for career advancement scheme and for assessing biodata of an academician for university teaching jobs. It allows 25 points for each research papers of a referee journal as notified by the UGC for single author. This score for paper in the journal is augmented on the basis of impact factor. Here comes the story. If impact factor is less than 1, it is augmented by 5 points. If it is between 1 and 2, by 10 points. Between 2 and 5, 15 points. By 5 and 10, by 20 points. And if it is above 10, it is augmented by 25 points. So, higher the impact factor of the journal in which you have published, higher will be your API score. So, please be careful and not fall in the trap of predatory journals who wrongly claim the high impact factor. If you want to verify the journal's impact factor, either you should have the list of impact factor issued by the agencies or simply type the name of journal in Google search bar. If it would have the actual impact factor, the Google would show in the box, otherwise not. However, it may not show you the current peer impact factor. We have shown in this slide that we have written that name of journal followed by the impact factor. So the Google has shown the 4.84 in the box for 2014. Next, other approaches. We can go through the websites of these agencies like Site Factor and other agencies. We can also have the list of impact factor there, or search individual publishers website like Bentham, Elsevier, Springer, and the reputed publishers, choose the journal from their list and then open their main page, their home page. The impact factor will be shown if exists with year and name of agency. But for other journals, please don't rely upon the impact factor shown in the main page. First check whether the journal is indexed in SCI or ESCI for science journals by checking the website of SCI. Now, what is the concluding remark? You can publish your work in good journals with impact factor even without paying even a single penny. Just search and target a good journal and give the justice to your hard work. Best of luck, friends. We humbly acknowledge Professor Gosani, Director, and Dr. Vijay, Deputy Director, Faculty Development Center, HNB Gadwal University, a central university, Srinagar Gadwal, India, for providing the opportunity to participate in short-term course on open education resources in higher education. All the participants of STC3 on OER in higher education All the resource person of SCC, Dr. Inderdeep Singh, Dr. Ritesh Shah, Dr. Jagdamba Prasad, Dr. Manas Ranjan Panigrahi, Professor S. Pani, Dr. Divikant Baghela, Dr. Hitesh Solanki, Dr. Manoj Divakar, Dr. Kiranlata Dangwal, and Professor Rajat Agrawal for inspiring the OER development. These are some of the references to which you can refer the further your knowledge, you can improve your knowledge, you can get yourself acquainted with more about the impact factor. So we will be back with other research indices soon. Stay tuned for more educational videos. Thank you for viewing. Please do share the video and subscribe our channel. Okay, Open Knowledge, Empowering Self-Learning, for forthcoming videos. Thanks.